सब्जेक्ट कोड 18CS2007 डेटा स्ट्रक्चर्स एंड एल्गोरिथम्स लैब एक्सपेरिमेंट नंबर 7 सर्चिंग एल्गोरिथम्स. इन दिस वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू सी सम सर्चिंग एल्गोरिथम्स लाइक लीनियर सर्च एंड बाइनरी सर्च. फर्स्ट वी स्टार्ट विद लीनियर सर्च एल्गोरिथम. दिस इज द लीनियर सर्च एल्गोरिथम फंक्शन व्हिच टेक्स टू इनपुट्स. दैट इज फर्स्ट वन इज द एरे एंड सेकंड वन इज द की दैट इज द डेटा दैट हैज टू बी सर्च्ड इन द एरे. सो वी विल स्टार्ट फ्रॉम द फंक्शन कॉल्ड हियर लीनियर सर्च इट टेक्स टू इनपुट दैट इज एरे. And the next one is key. So array we are prompting the user to enter the values for this array, and we are asking the user to enter the key that has to be searched in the array. So this algorithm takes two inputs. And in this function, under this function, we have a for loop to which helps us to iterate, I mean traverse across the list. So the range can be range should be length of the array, and I use the loop variable here, or else we can call it index variable also. And if a of i, that means the if, for example, the first iteration I will be 0 and second iteration I will be 1, right? In that manner, a of 0 gives the first element, a of 1 gives the second element, right? So we are checking if any of the elements in the array is matched with the key. If it is true, we'll return the corresponding index of that element. In the case of unsuccessful search, that means if the key is not present in the array, then this if condition will never be true, right? In any of these iterations, in any of these traverses, this if condition will never be true. So this for loop ends, and after that, we will return minus 1, which indicates unsuccessful search. That is about linear search. Now we'll see about binary search. So binary search takes 4 inputs. That is, first one is the array, second one is the load, that is the starting index of the array, up is the ending index of the array, and key is the data that has to be searched in the array. So we'll start from this function call. Binary search, it is first one is the array, second one is the load, that is starting index of the array. Since the starting index of array is 0, we are passing 0. Ending index of the array is length of array minus 1, right? So we are passing that one and a key that has to be searched in the array. So this algorithm takes 4 inputs. Okay. So here the recursive we are going to solve this binary search using recursive procedure. So the base condition for this recursion should be this one. If key equals to a of mid, we are returning the value. So I mean the index. So the main idea here is we have to pass the sorted array initially. So that's why here you can see that after getting the input for the array, we are sorting it. So using the sorted inbuilt printer in Python. So this algorithm works correctly for sorted array. It works for unsorted array also, but the output may be wrong for certain cases. So we have to pass sorted array to this binary search algorithm. So main idea here is to split. We will split the sorted array into two halves, and we check for whether the key that has to be searched is present in the either of the halves. If it is present in the first half, we'll search for the we'll further divide the first half into two parts, and we'll check whether the key is present in the first half or second half. And in that manner, we will keep on dividing and searching for this array. So we can call this as divide and conquer procedure, right? So if low less than or equals to up, that means if this whole procedure, that means this recursive procedure should work only if this condition is true. That means if low less than or equals to up, low is the starting index, right? Up is the ending index. So if low crosses the ending index of the array, that means the element is not present in the array. Imagine a situation where the array has two elements and the key has to be key that has to be searched is some other element. So if it is any unsuccessful search, so if this recursive call is made, then low and up will be 0 and 1, right? In case of just having only two elements, low will be 0 and up will be 1. So mid you will get as 1, right? So 1 by 2 will get 0. So mid will be 0, right? So while making this recursive call, a of low and mid will be 0. 0 minus 1 minus 1. So low and minus 1. Up will be minus 1, right? So low less than or equals to up. So here the condition fails, right? So in that case, this recursive procedure cannot execute. And it indicates that it is unsuccessful, which means the key is not present in the list. So we are returning the minus 1 to this function call. Or else we are following this recursive procedure, which is to divide the current array into two halves, that is starting index plus ending index, integer division by 2. Integer division gives us the integral part and it neglects the floating value. mid equals to low plus up integral division by 2. So if t equals to that middle position, that means if the key is present at the middle position of the array, that's it, we have finished, right? So we will return the corresponding index, that is mid. Or if the key, we'll check, we have two conditions, right? We'll check whether the key is present in the first half or if the key is present in the second half. If the key is present in the first half, that is left half, this recursion, this function call will be executed, right? So if if it is present in the first half, the upper index of this first array, I mean the splitted array, will be mid minus 1, right? So that one we have to update, we have to pass this area changed value to this function now. That's it. If low, a low, and now up will take mid minus 1 value and key will be as it is. That's it. And using this procedure, we'll solve this kind of we'll solve this binary search. Or else, if the array, if the element is key is present in the right side of the list, we'll follow this one, that is return binary search. Now the array should start from mid plus 1, right? So the starting index should be mid plus 1 and the ending index should be as it is. This is in the case of if the key is present in the right side of the array. So that's it. We'll try to run this. Before that, we'll see this menu, which is an infinite while loop, which prompts the user to select either of these two, linear or binary search. And third one is to exit. And if the user presses 1, we are prompting the user to enter the array elements. And we are using a map function to get the list of elements which are of type integer. This is to get the list, that list of elements, and we are converting that elements to int using this map function. And this map object we are converting into list. So that's what we are passing to this linear search array, and key value we are prompting the user to enter for this key that has to be searched. These two inputs we are passing to this linear search array. And next, if the user presses 2, it means that he needs binary search, and same thing, we are prompting the user to enter the array elements along the key. And in this case, we can see sorting method here. Sorted method, which sorts the array. As I've already told, that binary search needs the sorted algorithm. Sorted array. It doesn't. It cannot work fine with other. Unsorted array. So that's it. So we are passing this array, the starting index of the array, and the ending index of the array, and the key. So that's it. And after that, if the user possesses 3, he needs to exit, right? So we have to break this infinite while, or else we'll print invalid input for any other kind of input. Now we'll check if it's working or not. First we'll try for linear search. We'll take an array like this, value to be searched for. For example, we search for 5. Yes, we can see the corresponding index of 5 is 1. So 1 has been added. Now we'll try for unsuccessful search. Total search, linear search. We'll take the same array, once again 8, 9, 6, and we'll search for 7. We can see the algorithm return minus 1, so which indicates that 7 is not present in this array. Now we'll try for binary search. 10, 5, 8, 9, 6, okay, and we'll search for 8. We can see the index of 8 is 1, 0, 1, 2, right? So that index has been written. Now we'll search for, try for unsuccessful search. 10, 5, 8, 9, 6. Then it is searched for 7. Yeah, we can see the algorithm written minus 1, which indicates that 7 is not there in this present list. If the user wants to exit, 3. Yeah, that's all. The program has been finished. I hope all the outputs are correct for the different kinds of inputs that I have given. Thank you.